Welcome back to Pittsburgh as we get set for meeting number 129 between these two teams. Tonight's starting goaltenders, brought to you by Golden Corral. Help yourself to happiness. Anton Hudobin, that save percentage right now is third best in the National Hockey League. And Marc-Andre Fleury, his 60th appearance of the season, 36 wins, tied for second in the National Hockey League. And for Anton Hudobin, Tripp, this is an important night because he needs to be the backbone behind a team missing a few key parts.
And he's fresh. I mean, it was a late night of travel last night, even albeit a short distance from Ottawa.
Quick look at the officials. Mark Jonette, Rob Martel, the referees tonight. Johnny Murray, Scott Cherry on the line. Sit back and enjoy this one. Jussi Jokinen for Brandon Sutter. Shut down by Anton Hudobin. Sutter now in control, holding onto it. Jokinen celebrating his 31st birthday today, inside for Tanner Glass. Brandon Sutter hunts it down for Pittsburgh. Grinding now is Glass away for Jokinen, denied here by Carolina's Justin Falk. Falk tries to clear at the point. Matt Niskanen, he'll think about it. His wrister finds its way to the open corner. Sakara for Nathan Gerby and back out to center ice. 40 seconds gone here in period one. Fourth and final meeting, the Hurricanes looking for their first win. In four tries against Pittsburgh, only 1 point garnered in an overtime loss in Raleigh on December 27th. Chris Kunitz and a block by Ron Hainsey out in front, and he dumps it back out to neutral ice.
Anton Hudobin gives Hainsey a nice tap, and Hainsey stays on the ice here. Boy, some good defensive plays Hainsey made last night.
Eric Staal on Lee Stempniak. Play is whistled dead, and we get a stoppage. And they get their first chance, they being Pittsburgh, right off the hop.
Falk, this is a tough read early in the game. Just keep your eye on him, and that's going to create the chance. Jokinen rolls right off of it, knocks that puck out of midair, and finds another former Hurricane, Brandon Sutter, for the excellent chance. Skate onto the tape, and Anton Hudobin, a nice square butterfly save, and Falk, the coach, has felt was at his best in the third period after a tough stretch of hockey. That's an early tough read where you want to play a save for a game.
A line of Riley Nash, Jeff Skinner, Elias Lindholm, they stay intact. Some different units tonight for Kirk Muller. James Neal high on the glove side of Anton Hudobin. Jeff Skinner out to center ice. Pittsburgh has won their last two victories over Columbus, and then here's Sunday night over Chicago. 4-1, the final in that one. Icing is called here as we take a look at
That good start. And here on back-to-back nights, the guys really didn't put their heads on their pillows until about 2:30 this morning. Getting out of the first period even or better would be just fine against Dan Bylsma's club. And Dan told me this morning that his team has faced some adversity this season that they didn't last year, which he thinks will be a good thing. He doesn't mind the fact that they've run into a couple of difficult stretches.
Rex Express Care, injuries and scratches at the top of the screen. Rex Healthcare, chosen for excellence, notable for the Hurricanes tonight. Yuri Tlusti, who was injured last night in Ottawa, and Alex Semin, who was scratched earlier this afternoon. He's out with an illness, is now Hudobin puts it on a tee for Justin Falk.
Yeah, that's a tough one, and because of Semin's late illness issue, the small, medium, large line back together.
Shot taken from well out that time, was whistled high by Carolina's Andre Loktionov. It comes all the way back in the Carolina zone, and this is icing against Pittsburgh, and we see tonight's storm tracker.
Well, it starts with, to me, like a game recently in Winnipeg in a tough back-to-back. Getting out of the first period even or better. And Jordan needs a strong and powerful game against his former club that he won a cup with, and arrested Anton Hudobin after Cam Ward was sterling last night on back-to-back evenings.
Jordan is out there now with Nathan Gerby and Patrick Dwyer, John Michael Lyles, Ron Hainsey on defense. Lyles a one-timer off the blocker of Marc-Andre Fleury. Loose along the wall, Gerby attempts to dig it out for Carolina. It goes deep for Jordan. He'll swing it all the way back. Hainsey in control. His shot negated by Brian Gibbons, and here he comes. Gibbons walks in for a chance. Hooked at the last moment. And we'll see as Hudobin got back and the penalty shot is called.
Yeah, I think it's the right call. Gibbons, great speed after blocking the shot. He's a former Boston College Eagle, so two former members of Hockey East. Of course, Hainsey was a member of UMass Lowell. And I believe that Gibbons was in the clear and denied a good scoring opportunity as a result of the stick on the hands from Ron Hainsey, and that's why they called the penalty shot. Good block here from Gibbons. And Ron loses his footing, but then takes a good route to even get on the hands, and to me, that is the right call. Right on the hands underneath. And even when you do come underneath on the hands, it's a penalized play. Some could argue by coming underneath, it's a good defensive play. But in the rule book, if you catch the hands, even coming underneath, it's still an infraction. And if the player's in the clear and denied the scoring chance, you can have the criteria for a penalty shot.
66 penalty shots have been called this season. 20 goals have been scored. Anton Khudobin stopped Alex Ovechkin on January 2nd in Washington. And the rookie, Brian Gibbons, who started this season in the American Hockey League and has impressed everybody here, will get the chance. And now they're reviewing a situation here at the tail end of the sequence as to whether or not it went in.
Yeah, and that they're making sure. And now, as soon as there's any possession from Carolina, well, I certainly can't. It looks like it's not a good goal from that standpoint. It's a heck of a save there with the blocker side pad by Anton Khudobin. A more telling look here. Calling the ice was no goal, and that'll be no goal. And that, a very dramatic moment here early in the game. Khudobin was much better in his breakaways in the game since he gave up a couple to Sharp and Taves in Chicago recently.
Out of Boston College, born in Braintree, Massachusetts, Brian Gibbons on Carolina's Anton Khudobin. And the sellout crowd on their feet. A penalty shot early. Here comes Gibbons. He walks in, and Khudobin got a piece of it.
So patient. We talked about it with Craig Anderson stopping all three penalty shot attempts in the shootout last night. Anton's probably saying, hey, listen, Ron Hainsey came underneath, and it was a good legal play. He's a real communicator. Yeah, it looks like he doesn't get a piece, but I still think he creates his own luck by really waiting for Gibbons to make his move first. And Ron Hainsey did everything right to try to make a good play, but I still think that it was the right call to call that penalty shot.
Along the boards now, Dvorak through the middle of the ice. Dug out by Drayson Bowman. It goes by Manny Malhotra, by Fleury. Icing is called here against Carolina. When the Canes win tonight, all Caniacs win. Get 50% off your entire menu price online order at participating Papa John's the day after a Canes win. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
We talked about Khudobin working on his movement as a kid. He told me after the game Saturday against Columbus, he said it was his father, Valeri, who had a lot to do with his movement as a kid, along with other goalie coaches. So I just wanted to work in that element that Anton continues to tell us about his tutelage over across the ocean.
Jason Megna goes to work on Andre Sekera from the corner. Broken up by Drayson Bowman, denied by Craig Adams. They set it up again. Rob Scuderi paired on defense with Derek Englund. Laid off the boards by Carolina Sekera. Bowman takes a hit from Adams, and now Jason Megna, who scored his first goal in Raleigh as a Pittsburgh Penguin. First NHL goal. Set up the D, and they get it deep. Anton Khudobin looking for Sekera through the center zone, captured by Elias Lindholm. Carolina in the process of a line change, so Lindholm gets it deep. Getting to it now, their rookie defenseman, Olli Maatta, broken up here along the boards momentarily by Riley Nash. Lee Stempniak, ex of Calgary. Sidney Crosby all the way across for Kunitz. And it goes off Ron Hainsey. The pass intended for Stempniak. Niskanen shot patted down by Anton Khudobin. Nash away for Skinner. A loose puck as we see. And the Penguins get after it, but it's Elias Lindholm who clears it all the way in on Marc-Andre Fleury.
Khudobin, good save through traffic. What a look by Crosby on the rush.
Chance for Chris Terry, deflects wide. Now it's played again. The back of the goal by Terry. Skinner inside looking for Eric Staal. Back of the goal, Niskanen right out in front. Pittsburgh will survive as they get it out. Here's their captain, Sidney Crosby, with 99 scoring points. He throws on the brakes. James Neal's shot fought off and covered by Khudobin.
You're not going to find more of a shoot-first kind of guy in the league than James Neal. Nice job using the stick, corralling the rebound. Now, Anton Khudobin yelled across the locker room on Sunday morning before the team went to Ottawa. And I don't use nicknames, but he did, so I'm just going to repeat what he said. He said to Cam Ward, he said, hey, Wardo, I was looking at some film of me when I was 10 years old after the game which was Saturday night against Columbus, he said, I move just the same then as I do now. I'm just a little bit bigger. He was very proud of this. He went home and watched it. His father sent it to him. He watched it after the game on Saturday night, identified that motion and movement so important for him early on in Magnitogorsk.
Now it's broken up, carried out by Patrick Dwyer. Away for Nathan Gerby, approaching Robert Fortuzzo. They get it deep from the corner now. Carolina tries to establish a forecheck. Good block by Fortuzzo on Nathan Gerby. Back to the point, Jay Harrison. He delivers a pass hard around. Top of your screen, Jussi Jokinen. Now the Penguins reorganize with just about 5 minutes gone here in period one. John Tripp and Chantel with you as always. The Canes will come home and take on the Dallas Stars on Thursday night. You can see it right here, starting with Hurricanes Live at 6:30. Derek Englund through the center zone at the flex, and Jay Harrison is back on it.
It's funny, the hockey gods. As you're saying that, the puck's on Neil's tape, of course, part of a big deal from Dallas that has worked out very well for Pittsburgh.
With Matt Niskanen coming across, and he has had a career season. He's the only Pittsburgh defenseman that has played every game. And went seven games this season without their top 4D. Through the center zone now. Fended off that time by Hainsey. Turning is Drayson Bowman. Bowman starts his engine. Moves in over the line. A sweep check by Stempniak. It's loose, and Carolina's John Michael Lyles is on it.
For Bowman with speed, why not just soft chip that puck as a temporary loss of possession and not risk turning the puck over at the offensive blue line? Prior to that, did you see the seamless transition with Crosby? Top speed gathering that puck and coming out of his own end.
Pittsburgh needs 2 points. That's the magic number for the Metropolitan Division Championship in the regular season. 13:55 left to go in period one. Scoreless just underway in the Steel City. It's Moe's Southwest Grill. Hey, hey, what do you say? Queso players George Stahl. If he scores, all Caniacs receive a free side of Moe's famous queso and hot fresh chips tomorrow at any Triangle locale.
Well, even though the Hurricanes played last night, Jordan's 17 minutes and 23 seconds of ice time going overtime was less than his average this year. And for me, no more this Mr. Nice Guy, to quote Alice Cooper against his former team. His last playoff series as a Pittsburgh Penguin was against the Flyers, where there was a lot of hatred. He was the best player probably on either team, even though they lost the series. So, you know, you can be friends and nice guys after the game.
Olimata, Niskanen hammers one. A good save by Anton Hudobin. And the Hurricanes get it back out to the center zone. Olimata for Brian Gibbons, who was foiled on a penalty shot at 2:26 of period one. Now Sakara swings it back. It caroms in off of Justin Falk, and they set it up again. Falk in back of Hudobin. The forward line is Jordan Stahl, Nathan Gerby, and Patrick Dwyer. Falk's lead pass for Jordan. Jordan over the line. Mata and Gibbons on him. Goes to the corner. Detected by Matt Niskanen, whose plus-minus leads Pittsburgh at a plus 34 in the top five of the National Hockey League. Actually, he is in third in that regard behind David Krejci and Patrice Bergeron of Boston. Now in the center zone, it's carried by Jason Megna. In the Carolina end, his shot sealed off by Hudobin.
Boy, good speed, whether it be Megna or whether it be Gibbons to create the penalty shot. Hudobin holds on. Speaking of Russians and Hudobin, Loktionov is wearing a full eye tech because took this puck off of Phillips' stick, off his jaw, still almost scores, came back in the third period, then took another hit and had to leave the game, but he's back tonight. And he is showing some real grit coming back in this hockey game. And, of course, you want to protect yourself by going with that full eye tech.
Craig Adams, well over 800 games in the National Hockey League, a former ninth-round pick of the Hartford Whalers out of Harvard. As it comes back, and losing his footing was Brett Belmore. Carolina will get out of that. Neutralized Bortuzzo, turning stick of the aforementioned Adams, who lifts it deep. Getting to it is Belmore, pressured by Jason Megna. Out of the corner, Tanner Glass is there too for Pittsburgh. And now Megna in a stick battle, which he wins. He keeps it deep. But it's picked off by Belmore, who moves it this way for Jay Harrison. A steal by Adams off of Hudobin. Now Bortuzzo swings it across. Perfect. In the high slot, Craig Adams patted down as Hudobin gave up a rebound, but it's played here along the boards. Now Bowman tries to get it out, and the Hurricanes having a tough time in their own zone.
And a matchup of both fourth lines, and Pitt wins this one.
Here comes Jokinen, his shot off the stick of Hudobin. Jussi Jokinen skate to stick. They grind a cycle. Brooks Orpik lets it fly off the body. Off Malhotra. Now James Neal. Turning with it is Jussi Jokinen. Back to the point. Interrupted momentarily. Neal has it. His shot kicked out with a purpose by Hudobin. Getting to it, Jokinen. Neal again. Back to the point. Orpik inside for Jussi Jokinen. One-timer. Neal nullifies. Kicked out by Hudobin. And on it is Drayson Bowman, and finally, they get it out.
Boy, five guys are exhausted, and the crowd appreciates it because the fourth line sets the tone for the Penguins. Jussi Jokinen, the first guy on the ice for the next line, and that threesome keeps the puck in and creates some grade-A chances. Still 0-0, thanks in large part to Hudobin.
11 shots plus the penalty shot, 11-1. We saw the shots on goals, the Hurricanes. Cross the line offside, and we'll see the injury to Yuri Tulusti late in the second period in Ottawa.
Well, Yuri, so I mentioned this in the pregame show, Yuri would have liked to have taken more of a swooping approach here. Still Greiba, should have, I think, recognized he was in a tough spot. And Chris Terry, his first shift to this hockey game, had a real crisp, high-velocity pass. I'm not going to lie to you, I would have liked to have seen more of a pushback towards Greiba on behalf of Yuri Tulusti from his teammates. I think that can build chemistry for now and for later.
Stempniak turns it over to Ron Hainsey. Sidney Crosby is lurking, and now it's overskated by Stempniak. Kunitz scores! Chris Kunitz finds a way. Looks like the puck may have been tipped out in front. 10:59 left to go in period one. Pittsburgh on the board.
Five on the year for a guy out of Ferris State. Pretty incredible when you look at his rise through the NHL. Here he is. Let's just watch Kunitz in the neutral zone. Lyles, a defenseman, pinches up. Hurricanes still have pretty good numbers here. That's Crosby who makes the key play. Kunitz follows up. They've always had phenomenal chemistry, but this was all in the release. Does that go off of the shin pad of Ron Hainsey? Just off the far pipe and in. I'm not sure who Dobin saw it. It changes directions. However, Kunitz creates his own fortune by getting the puck to the net so quickly. He has very strong forearms. That was barely much of a shooting motion at all, but he's still got a decent amount on it.
Chris Kunitz gets the goal. Trip pointed out his 35th goal of the season. Lee Stempniak and Sidney Crosby get the helpers. 100 points now for Sidney Crosby for the fifth time in his brilliant career. The goal comes at 9:01, and Pittsburgh gets what they needed after all those shots, the game's first. We'll see if Carolina can counter that as they get it deep. Marc-Andre Fleury moves it along. This is Derek Englund back in his own zone. A quick up, chipped by Jokinen, gained by Andre Sekera.
I know this is the creme de la creme in the league. Oh boy, here we go. Englund going after Skinner. This is where you need the team to step up. I mean, this is something that is so crucial here on April 1st, not just for this season, but moving forward when you look at the pieces of this team that hopefully will grow together.
Sidney Crosby, as we pointed out, 100 points. 64 assists, lead the National Hockey League. And the interesting stat for him, probably more important than any of those numbers, as you pointed out during the open tonight, no man games lost for Sidney Crosby this season.
In this gorgeous arena right here in Pittsburgh, their regular season dominance in a Stanley Cup, this team might not even be in this city if Sidney Crosby did not land here. I mean, that is not an exaggeration. And you watch Hainsey here, trying to get out of the way. Looks like the puck grazes him. Either way, Hudobin can't locate it. But Crosby and Kunitz and the newly acquired Stempniak, but Crosby and Kunitz have always had great chemistry since they became teammates.
Pascal Dupuis was on that line, and he had a very serious knee injury earlier this season, about halfway through, and because of that, they had to go out and make a deadline deal. A couple of draft choices for Stempniak, who has fit in nicely on that top line. Jordan Staal in a four-on-four situation, matching penalties as Lyle's shot turned out easily by Fleury. Matching penalties to Derek Englund and Jeff Skinner. Kane's assistant, Dave Lewis, with Chantel McCabe. When we come back to Pittsburgh, right after this.
the first with Coach Dave Lewis. Pittsburgh has some very elite scorers. What do you want to see your defensemen doing out there?
Well, we got to protect the middle of the rink. We don't want to give them outnumbered situations, and we're trying to get our legs right now. They put a good attack on us right early, so we got to recover from that and just get going, play some zone time in their end.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And Dave wants to see if Justin Falk built on his third period last night, because he was much better than he has been for a stretch of games, and he had a bad read on the opening faceoff of this game that led to a Jokinen to Brandon Sutter chance. He's had a couple of better shifts since then. Here he is on 4-on-4 hockey. Let's see how he does.
And the 4-on-4, the result of two slashing penalties, matching penalties to Derek Englund and Jeff Skinner. Pittsburgh is a +2 in this situation this season. Goals for, goals against. Carolina -3. Olli Maatta, 19 years of age, in the back end with Matt Niskanen. The goal scorer, Chris Kunitz, through the middle. He'll pull up. Take a hit from Sakara. Now Niskanen on the flank. Crosby. He'll circle one out in front. Wedged wide by Maatta. Gained here by Justin Falk.
Boy, what a young rookie he is. Maatta, who played in the Olympics for Finland. Some thought he wouldn't even make the team, go back to London in the OHL. They gave him the game off against Columbus Friday.
Mm. And he wanted that. He said it was a good thing. Now it's played along here. Just take a breath. He's played a lot of hockey at a high level at this stage of his development. Now an outnumbered chance on a line change. Here they come. It's Dwyer holding onto it. His shot turned out by Marc-Andre Fleury.
Lyles, the defenseman, jumps in for the fun on the 4-on-4. Bad line change from Pittsburgh and a good early save, committing to the shot by Fleury.
Now Dwyer attempts a pass for Riley Nash. It springs back. Ron Hainsey paired now with Justin Falk. You see the time left in the 4-on-4 scenario. Falk this way for Dwyer. He makes a cut on a former teammate, Jussi Jokinen, and lays it along for Falk. Falk's in the zone, pulling up to the outside. Just wide on the glove side of Fleury, played here by Ron Hainsey. Off the stick of Jussi Jokinen. Riley Nash with a spinner, detected by Fleury. Manned by Rob Scuderi, and they start again. Bortuzzo on the wall, Megna. This way for the veteran, Rob Scuderi, as the penalized players have returned. We get back now to conventional 5-on-5. Nathan Gerby lifts the puck out to center.
Kunitz may have scored the goal, but I think you have to give the credit to Pittsburgh's fourth line and then Jussi Jokinen and his line mates coming on to just hem Carolina in. That's what created the momentum that eventually leads to the first goal.
Icing called against the Penguins. Shots are 13-4 favoring Pittsburgh.
John, 4-on-4, created chance. One defenseman, two, but here's a bad line change for Pittsburgh, and watch Lyles jump in to make this a 2-on-1. So Bortuzzo pinches when a line change is going on, but it's very, very well played by Rob Scuderi, the veteran and former LA King, but a member with Hal Gill, his partner of the Stanley Cup championship team here.
Icing again in consecutive fashion against Pittsburgh. We'll swing it back. 7:47 left in period one.
I think Scuderi is a very underrated piece, and he gave Marc-Andre Fleury the chance just to focus on the shot there. Boy, the chatter's going to really start in a couple of weeks for Marc-Andre Fleury, because what he's done in the regular season, everybody will be talking about the playoffs. But Scuderi missed a considerable period of time, about 2 months, with a lower body injury.
They have had well over 400 man games this season. 12 players have come up and played almost 200 man games from the American Hockey League. Craig Adams off the stick of Jay Harrison. Chris Terry takes a hit from Adams, but delivers a pass to Belmore, who broke his stick on the way out. Loktionov's after it. He's hit by Brooks Orpik. And now Craig Adams will clear it all the way back in the Kane zone.
The way teams are prepared these days, I'm sure Pittsburgh knows that Carolina has had trouble starting well, let alone when they played the night before. And good teams smell blood. And so far, with the territorial edge, Pittsburgh has smelt that blood in the first here tonight.
Justin Falk getting to it now. He'll circle. Played along the boards. Tied up by Taylor Pyatt as it pops out. Getting to it now is Rob Scuderi. Through the center zone and on the attack, Brandon Sutter. He'll pull up, move it by Falk. Inside it goes for Pyatt. Taylor Pyatt now drops it off. Broken up here by Jeff Skinner. Riding a 5-game point streak, he's out to center ice. Skinner, who scored his 30th last night, gets to the outside. His shot sealed off by Fleury. No further play.
Boy, I love seeing this from Skinner. Skinner made what would have been a 3-on-2, a 3-on-3, and then twice came underneath the puck at his own end to eventually come out with it and create a chance. I love seeing this as much as I love seeing any number of the 30 goals. Because when he can start doing that on a regular basis, he's really going to be a game changer. You see the lip service is coming from the Pittsburgh bench. He's better just to stick with his game plan. But when Loktionov and Talusti went down last night, I thought he was as big of a leader in an all-around capacity as the Hurricanes had last night. But this is the game plan for any team, to try to get under his skin. He's got to be better than that.
Off the faceoff now. Turning with it is Nathan Gerby. Jordan Staal centers one, and a good stick check coming back by Lee Stempniak on Pat Dwyer. And Dwyer comes across and levies a hard hit on Stempniak. Now getting to it for the Hurricanes is Lyles, away on the wall for Dwyer. Broken up by Lee Stempniak. In the middle of the ice, Kunitz. He'll delay. Shoot one well high over Anton Hudobin. Played here by Jordan Staal. Through neutral ice, skate to stick, Gerby drops it off for John Michael Lyles, denied by Bortuzzo, and the Pens start again. They give it away at dead center. The Hurricanes now deflect it back. Fleury melts it down and will step aside. 5:51 left to go in the opening period. Chris Kunitz has the game's only goal. Pittsburgh off early.
Back in Pittsburgh, and you'll want to make sure you tune into both intermissions tonight as Ron Francis, who won two Stanley Cups with the Penguins, is in the Twitter Lounge in a two-part piece. He explains how he celebrated with the Stanley Cups, plus his transition to management. The great Hall of Fame player answers your questions from UKaniacs. Don't miss it.
Two parts in the Twitter Lounge for the Canes executive. That's pretty good.
Right, and I'll always remember, I know the Hurricanes didn't end up winning the Stanley Cup, but his goal in overtime from Jeff O'Neill of Game 1 in Detroit in 2002 to beat Dominic Hoskins.
Jeff Skinner tries to swing one out in front. It deflects back to Andre Sequeira, walking the line on James Neal. Right at the Dvorak goes deep for Carolina. Skinner in control, double shifted on this line with Malhotra and Dvorak. Inside for Carolina's 53, Olimata is on him. Along the boards now, Bo Bennett for Pittsburgh. Jussi Jokinen in the skates of Niskanen. Folk with a shot, he scores! Justin Folk breaks it off Marc-Andre Fleury, and the Hurricanes have tied it.
Boy, good to see a heavy, heavy offering from Folk. I give Skinner a lot of credit here for competing for the puck with Malhotra and Dvorak along the boards, which eventually leads to a puck spinning out to the middle of the ice. And keep your eye on Falk here. He's the eventual goal scorer. I love the work here. Look at Skinner come in to help out. That helps to create, I think, the turnover. And Fleury can't get himself set. I can't tell if it hits anything, but it goes maybe underneath the arm on the blocker's side. But that's a difficult shot to get off that quickly for Falk. Would have been much easier if he was a left shot. So that's a boost for him.
Pass now deflects back out to neutral ice. So Justin Falk gets the goal. Carolina as he breaks it off of Fleury. Now the Hurricanes start again. And the person of Eric Staal, forechecked on the way out. Centering pass as Brandon Sutter was taken down. No call is made. And Andre Loktionov has control. 14:39 is the time of the goal. As Justin Falk gets an unassisted goal to tie the game.
Well, Jussi Jokinen tried to find Niskanen, the defenseman, in the middle of the ice. And even if it's the right play, if you don't execute it in the middle of the ice, Dave Lewis was talking about the middle of the ice, it's going to lead to an opportunity for the other team. And that's a big moment there for Justin Falk as he expects more of himself offensively.
Craig Adams feeds it in. Andre Sequeira looks around. Adams again on the forecheck. Riley Nash attempts to move it. Tanner Glass looking for Adams. At the point, Derek Englund. He'll go deep. Pass intended for Jason Megna, who has control. As they grind a cycle, it goes by Tanner Glass. Justin Falk now with a shoulder on him. Nash deep in his own zone. Starts the play. Sequeira retreats in back of Anton Hudobin, and they start over. Here's Elias Lindholm. Indirect pass off the boards, a lead one for Riley Nash. Good look at he along with Rob Scuderi, broken up by Nash this way for Nathan Gerby. Gerby shot, caught off by Fleury as it kicks back to Jason Megna, and Pittsburgh will survive.
Yeah, Fleury looks to be perhaps fighting it a bit tonight, and you want to make sure, all the more reason to throw pucks at the net.
Nathan Gerby attempts to wheel one out in front. out of the corner. Englund going hard at his man. It's Pat Dwyer. It squirts out. Rob Scuderi pestered by Nathan Gerby. Jordan Stahl. Back it goes. Shot taken by Belmore. Is stopped by Fleury. And no further play.
Well, the middle was open. Watch here, Niskanen. But the puck, he can't corral it off of UC. And then I think it goes maybe off of the inside of Fleury's blocker and in the net. Niskanen comes out, tries to go down. That may have impacted the sight lines of Marc-Andre Fleury. But for Justin Falk to lean into that quickly was nice.
Fleury answers right off the faceoff a couple of times here. The initial shot taken by Jay Harrison. Olimata for Lee Stempniak. Hurricanes have some energy after the goal is scored by Justin Falk as it comes all the way back.
Remember, our top game key, even or better after the first. So you take this right now if you can get to the locker room with it.
Jeff Skinner on and off his stick. Niskanen defense for Pittsburgh. Olimata looks around. On the flank now, they assert out to center. The top line is out for Dan Bylsma. A lead pass off Hainsey, but Crosby was in early and offside.
I've got Skinner as the biggest leader up front again in this opening period. You know, we showed the one shift where the Pittsburgh bench was trying to get under his skin. Well, all he did was come out on the fourth line with Malhotra and Dvorak, helped to create that turnover from UC to Niskanen in the middle, and Falk did the rest. So I love the hunger that Jeff Skinner is showing. You look at some of the most adverse times this year, Montreal, New Year's Eve, the Islanders after they get up 4-0. Last night, Jeff Skinner is a leader.
Puck is carried in onside by Jussi Jokinen. Dealt along for James Neal. And now Eric Staal. Through the center zone on the attack is Chris Terry. He'll get it deep. Bortuzzo pushed by Andre Loktionov. Chris Terry going down with Brooks Orpik on him. Out of the corner scrum. Loktionov had it, lost it. James Neal now advances back out. A headman feed for Jussi Jokinen. Detected beautifully by Justin Falk. Here comes Loktionov, but the Hurricanes are offside. The free scam is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light. We'll take a look back at the penalty shot.
Well, we talked about it in the shootout last night. A goalie never wants to make the first move. And when you don't make that first move and show your hand, the puck can get up on edge and a player can't control it like he wants to. And Gibbons there just ran out of real estate because Hudobin was so patient and tries to go to the forehand and doesn't even get the shot on goal. But patience was the virtue to create it.
Usually is. Now Lyles rolled in. Derek Englund in control around the boards, intended for Brian Gibbons. It squirts out off the stick of Lindholm and slammed ahead by John Michael Lyles.
You look at Gibbons, you look at Orpik, you look at Nathan Gerby. A nice showing for Boston College Eagles in this game.
Sidney Crosby lays it through the center zone, detected by Lyles, and here they come again. Moving up, a shot taken by Lindholm, fended off by Fleury. Loose along the board, Skinner. Elias Lindholm tries to advance out in front. Moving on Rob Scuderi. Inside for Skinner. He'll dangle. Jeff Skinner just by his man, Riley Nash. And the Penguins now transition. Here comes Crosby. Sidney Crosby's backhander off the glove of Hudobin. Loosened back of the goal, fought for. As it comes out here to Jeff Skinner, and out they go. Skinner in control in the skates of Jordan Stahl. Stahl looks for a friend to pass to. He's defended by Olimata. Stahl going down on his own accord. Jordan gets back up. Now it's Patrick Dwyer. Jordan with a shot. Kicked out by Fleury. Under a minute left in period one. To the point, it goes by Harrison, and the Hurricanes retreat.
Hurricanes have been a different team in the final 10 minutes of this period than they were in the opening 10. I love that play that Lyles made. He's really jumped in nicely on a couple of occasions here. And you saw Crosby. He has the best backhand in the game with that stick without much of a curve.
Now Olimata for Matt Niskanen with 35 seconds left in period one. Lead pass for Taylor Pyatt. And they picked up off waivers from the New York Rangers. Offside is called here. 30.1 seconds left in period one.
Remember Lyles jumping in with Dwyer to create a 2-on-1 and a 4-on-4 in this period. And here, look at this little tight pass. And he, you know, gets Crosby to step up and not be able to make the play. And Fleury, who has scored on the blocker side, has a nice challenging stop with the same piece of equipment there. It's good to see from Lyles.
We talked about that tandem during Hurricanes Live tonight. Ron Hainsey, John Michael Lyles. Now those two have found some harmony here. Now it's carried along by James Neal. Brett Belmore gets to it with that long reach. 20 seconds left in period one. And now it's carried out by Bortuzzo. Bo Bennett rolls it inside. Out of the corner now, it comes back to James Neal. His shot goes high. Bortuzzo sends it deep. 3 seconds left in the period. Carolina will fend that one off as the horn sounds here in Pittsburgh. Justin Falk will be Chantel McCabe's guest. We also have Ron Francis in the Twitter lounge. That'll do it after 20 here in Pittsburgh. The Hurricanes and the Penguins deadlocked at one. Carolina Hurricanes hockey is brought to you by Kangaroo Express, your home of the $1.50 dog and drink. By Moe's Southwest Grill, welcome to Moe's. And by the North Carolina Education Lottery. Play Powerball with Power Play from the North Carolina Education Lottery and get in the game. Jackpot start at $40 million. Back inside Consol Energy Center here in Pittsburgh, ready for the second period. Sidney Crosby already on the score sheet tonight. Coors Light cold hard facts involving Pittsburgh's number 87. Points per game leaders among active players. And yes, Jaromir Jagr is still very active. Had a great game last night, the former Penguin. Now as a Devil in trip, we'll see him in Raleigh on Saturday night.
As impressive as of a statistic, when you look at the points per game numbers, Jagr is a plus 14. Sidney Crosby in the first period was a plus 1, so that makes him plus 16 on the year. And you look at that graphic, look at Alex Ovechkin's plus minus, way down on the other side of the minus department. That's how you win in this league, when you complement the scoring with defensive responsibility.
Ovechkin did not have an even strength point in the month of March.
Well, that is the tail of the tape, and that is one of the big reasons that Washington is fighting like crazy for their playoff lives, and Pittsburgh's trying to win a division two-way hockey from the Capitals.
Second period unfolds here in Pittsburgh. John Forslund, Tripp Tracy, Chantel McCabe, along with our fine crew, wedged in on Marc-Andre Fleury, who melts it down.
Brandon Sutter, actually, these are two former Hurricane members.
Yes.
On the training side, too, and Jordan Staal and Sutter get entangled with one another, and Brandon's...
Oh boy,
you know, the blade of his stick finds that little slit in the boards, and then it absolutely knocks the wind right out of you. Hopefully he's okay.
You're talking about Chris Stewart, who is the fine medical side of the ledger for the Pittsburgh Penguins, their trainer, and in the Stanley Cup season in Carolina, he was the assistant trainer underneath Pete Friesen.
So any team searching to try to win the Cup should probably try to see if it's a contract year for him, because he seems to have the Midas touch.
Goes all the way across for Andrei Loktionov. Sidney Crosby with Lee Stempniak and Chris Kunitz. Here they come. Good pass for Brooks Orpik in the skates of Chris Terry on the back check. Now we look at Eric Staal. He's peppered by Rob Scuderi. A loose puck in the center zone, captured by Andre Sekera.
There's two or three more levels in Eric Staal's game here. He went 2 of 7 in the faceoff circle, was minus 1 in the first period. They're a tough turnover. And you know, he needs to be able to follow, I think, what Skinner did to lead up front there in the opening period.
Well, he certainly needs to elevate his wingers. Loktionov in a call-up, Chris Terry. So we'll see how it continues here tonight. Sekera holding onto it. Andre Sekera to the outside. He'll wind it deep for Elias Lindholm on a cycle. Lindholm cutting out in front, intended for Sekera. Justin Falk, who has Carolina's goal, plays it along the boards for Riley Nash. He overskated it. Jussi Jokinen cushions off for Brooks Orpik, and they start again. Here's Rob Scuderi through the center zone on a change. Jokinen's in. His shot swallowed by Anton Hudobin. Let's take a look at the first period numbers, brought to you by Buffalo Brothers. Aw, man, now I want wings.
And I'm just going to add one more wrinkle to why I like Skinner's first period. A 33-second average shift length. Back-to-back nights, that's outstanding. Justin Falk, who scored Carolina's only goal, 39 seconds, which is as good when a defenseman typically has a longer shift length, so that's a good start.
Off the faceoff, Derek Englund. Inside, Jason Megna. Rubbed out by Jay Harrison. Now Tanner Glass. Indirect pass, Englund. His shot tipped wide of Hudobin. Loose this way. Getting to it now is Radek Dvorak. He'll move it back. Jay Harrison looks around. He gets some help from Drayson Bowman and back out to the center zone.
Bowman, whose average shift length in the first period was over a minute. So he'll want to improve upon that. The only other player in the game that had a length over a minute was Megna on the other side for the Panthers.
No icing here. Udobin for Harrison, pinned a bit by Craig Adams. Adams had it, lost it to the point. Niskanen, his shot caught by Udobin. And he leaves it there for Jay Harrison.
Hurricanes have done a good job of keeping this sellout crowd out of the game. It's a pretty quiet building thus far this evening.
It is. Now it's reversed. Pittsburgh will hit the road for three after this one tonight. To the point, Lyles with a bit off the body. They go to Winnipeg, Minnesota, and Colorado. See a lot of east-west here late in the season, which is unusual from a scheduling perspective. Now it comes back.
We'll see Dallas. Usually you love to call that game the holiday classic, but we're not around any holidays right now unless you consider April Fool's a holiday.
I do. Now it's knocked down. Played in back of the goal. Gibbons all the way back. Bortuzzo, Orpik holding, looking for a tip. It goes off the stick of Brandon Sutter. Controlled here by Nathan Gerby.
That was better from Captain Eric Staal. Good tight coverage on Brandon Sutter. Good to see Sutter back healthy.
Gerby, wide of Fleury. He gets in it and tries to make it happen. Now it's broken up. Carried out by Sidney Crosby off the stick of Eric Staal out to center ice. Stempniak overskated. Now Kunitz denied at the line by Sequeira. Turning is Andre Loktionov. He'll hand it off to the captain. Eric Staal's pass. He takes a second swat at it, and now Pittsburgh gets control. Lee Stempniak can't dangle by Andre Sequeira as they battle along the boards. It's loose. Loktionov for Carolina, and away they go.
Well, he takes an extra second when he has time. He gets it out when he should.
Dustin Pulp, defended by Brooks Orpik. Loose in back of the goal. Knocked down by Andre Loktionov. Pushed again by Orpik. Orpik along the boards. Loktionov working hard for Carolina. Just over 4 minutes gone in the second period. Back to the point. Falk in control. He'll wrist it deep. It was blocked on the way through by Chris Kunitz as he attempts to get it out. And he's peppered by Eric Staal. Let's see who wants it here as it kicks around. And finally it's controlled and carried by Chris Terry. This way for Eric Staal. Eric now shifting gears on his backhand, holding onto it. Off a skate. It's loose, fended off by Bortuzzo. Played by Jeff Skinner, who whips it across for Elias Lindholm. Taken down by Stempniak. And now the Penguins restart.
Other than the penalty shot, 5-on-5 hockey in this game. Referees are letting him play.
Brooks Orpik now, who was somewhat of a controversial figure on Sunday with his hit on Jonathan Toews, depending on how you look at it. He was injured on the play. It was a big-time hit as Udobin melts it down. April 16th, two bitter rivals step in to coach the UFC's next generation of fighters as they go head-to-head with a UFC contract on the line. The all-new season of The Ultimate Fighter, Team Edgar versus Team Penn, begins April 16th only on Fox Sports 1 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go.
I forgot about those two minors to Skinner and Englund in the first period for that 4-on-4 sequence, but other than that, no power plays for either club.
Off the faceoff, Belmore. Sent deep by Derek Englund. Getting to it here is Ron Hainsey. In the center zone, a chip as it rolls in by Fleury. That chip from Drayson Bowman. Radek Dvorak tries to make it happen. Now Holtra along the boards now, grinding is Drayson Bowman. His pass detected momentarily by Englund, who attempts to recover. Now it's carried again by Bowman. Looking for Manny Malholtra. Back-checking is Jussi Jokinen. Jussi now will glove it down, try to get it out, and they do. Bo Bennett out to center ice. The Southern California native will get it deep.
He's a good one. Recently came back from an upper body injury, played at Denver, a first-round draft pick, and a right shot. They don't have a lot of that up front, right-handed finishers.
He has scored in both games back. Now it's carried here by Craig Adams. His shot deflects wide of Udobin. Olimata now inside. Jason Megna turning with it on a cycle is Craig Adams. He'll stop and start, broken up by Falk, and away they go. Back out to center ice, it's Gerby. Off the stick of Jordan Staal. He'll attempt to hunt it down. Jordan gets to it. Around the boards, captured here by Pittsburgh's Tanner Glass, and away goes Jason Megna. Megna to the outside. No angle here. He's defended by Justin Falk. Little help from Nathan Gerby, and now Adams for Pittsburgh. Craig Adams in back of Udobin. Brooks Orpik at the point, swings it across. It's Bortuzzo. His pass to an open wing, and Sequeira looks around.
Bortuzzo out of Thunder Bay has been a real find. Gives this blue line some more grit and toughness, which I think will help them in the playoffs and make them better.
out to center ice. In control now is Brandon Sutter. He'll get it deep. They need 2 points, Pittsburgh, to clinch the division title. And they are well in back of Boston right now, who has number one in the Eastern Conference. Just about 7 minutes gone to the second period. It's a 1-1 standoff here in the Steel City.
We're tied at one in Pittsburgh, but last night in Ottawa, Cam Ward allowed an early goal in the first period, but he stayed in the game mentally and took the team to a shootout. In his eyes, that wasn't enough, bringing us to our Geico quote, where Ward said last night after the game, the only way you're satisfied is if you're walking out of there with 2 points. Unfortunately, we fell short. It wasn't the lack of effort. I think the guys worked extremely hard in front of me. John?
There's no doubt about that, and it has been a mental battle for Cam Ward, but he's really coming around.
Well, if you can get through adversity and survive it, you'll be better for it, and you'll be a better player, you'll be a better person. And for Cam Ward, he has had two outstanding road starts in Winnipeg and last night in Ottawa. And I love the candid nature of his comments. I love what Rod Brind'Amour said going into the third period, that the team hadn't played well last night. I mean, this is not a good spot to be in. And that's why this is such an important opportunity against a Pittsburgh team that is a measuring stick and has had Carolina's number the last couple of years. This is not just a ho-hum game. This is a very important contest for still a very young core to build the type of chemistry and confidence needed to move forward.
And playing without Jiří Tlusty and Alex Semin due to injury tonight as they cross offside. And Pittsburgh was out shooting Carolina 11-1 in the early going, but now it's 16-11, so Kirk Muller's team has bounced back as they have outshot Pittsburgh since then 10-5.
Well, do you want to go quietly into the night and allow a team to capture a division championship the first year of the Metropolitan Division? Absolutely not. I mean, if you get a big win on the road, down a few key bodies tonight, you have no idea what it can do for this young core in terms of their team confidence moving forward into the seasons to come.
Now Anton Hudobin will move it. James Neal for Bo Bennett, a good stick check coming all the way back that time to help out. With John Michael Lyles. Now Bortuzzo finished off by Chris Terry. James Neal from his own zone, directly off the boards and back out to neutral ice.
Terry's details, they're finishing a check. His back checking, a back pressure play earlier in this period, his passing have been good tonight.
Bakhtianov, fended off by Fleury. Played here by James Neal. He'll move it back. Pittsburgh now a bit disorganized as they attack out to center ice. It's picked off by Justin Falk. Falk hits the line. Swept along by Orpik, but not out. Played here by Justin Falk to the outside of James Neal, and it caroms all the way back.
Falk is lucky that Neal is not a physical player, because he put himself in a very difficult spot there, where if you had a guy that was looking, well, if Orpik was there, we might have an issue right now.
We have a penalty upcoming against Pittsburgh, though, as Neal took down Justin Falk, so six skaters out for the Hurricanes with 11:35 left in the second period. Andre Sequeira moved along for Riley Nash. Through the center zone, Pittsburgh takes over, and now Carolina, a man up.
When I say that, I'd love to have Orpik on my team. And he was on Dan Bylsma's team. Dan Bylsma's team is going to be shorthanded for the first time in this hockey game. A tripping call coming up. I asked Dan this morning, I said, Dan, when did you decide in the preliminary round to keep going back to TJ Oshie for consecutive shootout attempts? And he said, Trip, that's why he made the team. It's a trip to James Neal. And he either didn't recognize it or tried to somehow get out of it, stick between the legs of Falk. And Dan Bylsma said after the first three shooters against Russia, he thought about using Parise or Kane, but said that's why, one of the reasons he picked Oshie on the team, or at least the management group did, led by David Moore. And what a memory that was at the Oshie show there in Sochi.
Yeah, he became a household name after that. About 9 minutes gone in the second period. First power play tonight for the Hurricanes. 29th overall, 27th on the road. Pittsburgh number four on the kill and third best here at home. Fleury to the wall, Lakhdianov. Back to the point, Jay Harrison. This way for Riley Nash. Inside it goes for Skinner. Jeff Skinner now sets up shop, holding onto it. Pittsburgh disciplined in that box, and now it's Lakhdianov. Inside for Skinner. Up top, Lindholm shut down by Fleury. Out of the corner, Lakhdianov, the point man. Jay Harrison, they work it nicely. Goes by Andre Lakhdianov. Here's Jeff Skinner dragging. Lindholm scores! That's That's hockey, baby. What a play by Jeff Skinner to Elias Lindholm on the power play. Carolina up by one.
It's the youngest players that are pushing this team right now. Jeff Skinner continues to be a very impressive leader. Look at the motion. Nobody was ever standing still, and now Skinner makes an absolute high-level skill play. Everybody thinks he's going to the other side, probably including Fleury, probably including the defenseman Mata, finds the passing seam, and Lindholm finishes quickly with elevation, and his quick move is to point out the pass that was made. What a beautiful power play goal.
Outstanding play by Jeff Skinner, and a great finish by Elias Lindholm for his seventh goal of the season. The Hurricanes up by one. Patrick Dwyer gets to it. Matt Niskanen on him, and now James Neal, who took the penalty, sails it all the way back in the Carolina zone, and Hudobin is out to play it. They move it around the boards. Picked off by Neal. Neal goes inside for Jussi Jokinen. Jokinen to the outside now, holding onto it. Readying for a shot was Olli Maatta. Maatta, a wrister through traffic, wide of Hudobin, loose to the corner. Getting to it now is Lyles, chipped out of the zone by Nathan Gerby, and we see it come all the way back. Andre Loktionov gets an assist too on the goals. Crosby's second chance is blocked by Ron Hainsey. Now it's free. Sidney Crosby along the boards. His pass. Olli Maatta brought it back in offside, and we get a whistle. 9:42 left to go in the second period. Just another happy moment for Carolina's 19-year-old Elias Lindholm. Canes up by one. As Lindholm getting it done in the power play, so now you can stop by any participating Bojangles between 5:30 and 10 a.m. tomorrow morning and say, I'm a Caniac and it's Bo time to get your free Bojangles Bowberry Biscuit. Log on to CarolinaHurricanes.com/Bojangles for rules and participating locales.
Watch the motion. Here's Skinner, Loktionov, and the eventual score right here, Lindholm. Love to see this motion. Nobody's ever standing still. Lindholm finds a nice little soft area. Of course, it's an exceptional pass. But when you're moving your feet, you find areas, and Lindholm scores a beauty as the youth again continue to drive the ship here for Carolina tonight.
Chris Terry in control, moved all the way back. Andre Sekera forechecked a bit, broken up by Lee Stempniak. It kicks out. Terry's on it, and away they go. Chris Terry at his side, Justin Falk. His winder wide of Fleury, loose side of the goal, taken care of by Rob Scuderi, but not out. Justin Falk, a good pass, Loktionov, blocked by Derek Englund. Overskating is Andre Sekera. Andre Loktionov now goes deep. Eric Staal along the boards. Crosby is on him. It's loose. Terry gives chase, but getting to it is Rob Scuderi.
I'm a Loktionov believer. It's still early, but thus far I'm a definite believer.
Eric Staal with a steal. His pass detected. He gets it back. Sets up a man. Here's Sekera walking, shooting one. High over the top of Fleury. This way it's Eric. Belmore's shot caught by Marc-Andre Fleury.
I think that Terry has done some nice things in this game. Away from the puck, showing that he was ready to start the game on time. Look at him come in way from the boards, create 5 men in the picture, and a player that is not known for being fast looked pretty fast there because he played a direct game. I like that route.
Right now the Hurricanes are doing exactly what Kirk Muller said during Hurricanes Live in terms of getting at Pittsburgh, who had rest. Definite advantage with the schedule tonight, and the Hurricanes with a disjointed lineup. So far, so good. Skinner out in front, forked wide by Riley Nash.
And in hockey terms, what Terry just did there is called the slash. Very important to the way that Carolina plays when they're on. Skinner nearly set up another goal there.
Brett Belmore in control. They hinge it back out to center ice. It deflects all the way in. No icing. Robert Bortuzzo is on it, and he'll move it. The angular defenseman out to center, played here by Taylor Pyatt. He gave it away to Drayson Bowman in Carolina now, as we see, by two. In terms of scoring chances, there's another that never should have happened. And Fleury shut down Drayson Bowman.
And the Hurricanes are getting some bounces, but they've got guys going to the net and paying the price and nearly convert on a fluky.
Scrum in the corner. And we see it up close. Taylor Pyatt Grinds along for Pittsburgh. Gets a little help from Brian Gibbons. Craig Adams inside for Pyatt. The back of the goal, there's Gibbons. Punched out by Hainsey. His pass defended beautifully by Ron Hainsey. Off the boards and back out.
Hainsey guilty of that penalty shot early. Boy, has he recovered.
Another chance to flex wide of Fleury. Bowman centers one. Matt Niskanen was there. Now Bowman one more time. Broken up here by Craig Adams. Elevating the puck back out to center ice. Andre Sekera away for Radek Dvorak with a cross-corner dump in. Matt Niskanen looking over his shoulder at Jordan Staal. Dvorak cut it off. Radek Dvorak along the boards. Swept back out to neutral ice, and the Hurricanes restart.
Drayson Bowman's second period has been, in my view, significantly better than his first.
Jordan Staal, good pass over the line. Dwyer's shot goes wide of Fleury. Patrick Dwyer moves it deep. Gerby, Jordan, backhander shut down by Fleury. To the point, Sekera, a wrister blocker down by Fleury. Getting to it is Niskanen. And all they can do here is ice it. And we'll swing it back in the Pittsburgh zone.
Dan Bylsma may have to call his timeout here because not only does he have some tired players in front of Marc-Andre Fleury, but Carolina has all the momentum. This puck, Fleury can't play it. Trapezoid probably coming into play, and then the worst thing the goaltender ever wants to do is get caught in a situation where the puck is between him and the goal. Because then you want to make sure it doesn't hit you, and then you're trying to locate it, and Bowman's actually driving the front of the net and nearly scores. And Dan Bylsma, a couple of nights ago against Chicago, called a timeout in the third period when his team was not playing well, and Sidney Crosby responded with two goals. He was very animated on that timeout. You could see his again right here.
He's looking to become the fastest coach to 250 wins if he gets this one tonight. But as you can tell by how animated he is, if it continues down this road for Pittsburgh, it's not going to happen tonight. 6:36 left in the second period. Scoring chances in the second period. Carolina 6. Pittsburgh has not had one.
Yeah, I don't remember the last time that Hudobin was truly challenged. He was good early in the first period to only give up the first goal of the game on that slight little redirection off of Kunitz's tape.
Out to center ice now. Megna will move it. Hainsey shadows him. Jason Megna, born and reared in South Florida. Stuck out here by Jussi Jokinen. Jokinen out in front, good stick. Defensively, it was Jay Harrison. Here come the Hurricanes. The outside at the line, it's Chris Terry, taken down by Rob Scuderi. Out of the corner now, Jokinen springs a man, it's Bo Bennett, and away they go. He's playing catch with James Neal, who cuts. His shot deflects wide. Getting to it is Andrei Loktionov. Sealed off, but losing his edge was Jokinen. Fed along by Neal. Bo Bennett, holding, right out in front, defended by Jay Harrison. Harrison tries to move it. Forechecked by Bo Bennett. Moved by Jussi Jokinen to the point. Derek Englund will wrist it along. The turning stick of Jokinen diagonally across for Rob Scuderi. Right on the tape now. Moved here by James Neal. Bo Bennett in back of Hudobin. Holding onto it. Guarded by Loktionov. Andrei Loktionov attempts to play it well, and he does, forcing him to the outside. Playing it now is James Neal for Bo Bennett. Sealed off along the boards by Jay Harrison. 5:23 left in the second period. Now a foot race. Derek Englund got there first around the boards and controlled here and brought out of the zone by Chris Terry.
And puck, see if it can get all the way deep. Boy, Loktionov had a chance to get the puck out. He wasn't able to, and Pittsburgh, a couple of good chances. You can see the benefit of the timeout.
Here's a steal. Lindholm scores! What a rocket! Elias Lindholm with his second goal tonight. Carolina by a pair.
Chris Terry did not get the puck deep, but he was able to follow it up and pressure just enough that his two line mates, Loktionov and Staal, watch the right side of your screen, are able to make a line change. And then Terry ends up coming back and helps to force the turnover. Great moment for him. And then the top tier first rounder scores his second of the period. Absolutely awesome release on the part of Elias Lindholm. Skinner factoring in again. Skinner has had a central part in all three goals here this evening. Wow, I love seeing this take charge attitude from Jeff Skinner that I think truly began in earnest in the third period last night in Ottawa.
The water bottle gets in the way. Fleury, tough time getting it out. Here's Nash, a wrap chance, denied by Fleury. Brandon Sutter tries to move it, and now it's Brian Gibbons out to center ice. You're looking at Taylor Pyatt. Now Brooks Orpik, his shot easily detected by Anton Udobin. 4:36 left to go in the middle session. Lucky Lindy is having a night in the Steel City. It's all about fun, and this kid is having fun tonight. What a night so far for Elias Lindholm.
Great to see him smiling. He loves Jeff Skinner. They spent a lot of time together off the ice. And here's the play that Terry makes first, and then Skinner, and then the follow-up from Elias Lindholm as he goes high cheese. Remember early in the year in October, talked about beating Lundqvist, and we said, well, where would you beat him? He said, well, high cheese. He ended up scoring on Lundqvist later on this season. And that puck just avoids being a delay of game penalty.
Close.
Good to see Lindholm firing that puck so quickly and with authority.
Well, he's playing with a swagger and has been for a while. Three shots in this game. You see the first career two-goal game of what we hope is many for Elias Lindholm. But this line has emerged now as Carolina's best troika. Nash, Skinner, Lindholm.
Leadership. I mean, the leadership's coming from the youngest players on the team. There's no doubt about it.
The assist to Jeff Skinner. The goal at 14:57. Second tonight, eighth of the season for Elias Lindholm. 4:10 left to go in the second period. John Tripp and Chantel with you as always. Don't forget part two. Ron Francis. Tweet a Kane tonight. Kane's executive in the Twitter lounge. Part two during our second intermission tonight. Niskanen, one-timer Mata, locked in front. Controlled by Andre Sekera and back out.
And we began the night talking about Crosby and Skinner. Both used the same trainer in the summer.
Brandon Sutter off a stick and a collision as Crosby jammed the front of the goal and Dobin was able to hold his ground.
That Duchesne also uses, I believe the trainer's name is Andy O'Brien, and his biggest catalyst is his ability to improve fast players' explosive nature. And you can see a difference this year from Skinner, and Crosby seems to get quicker every year. A lot of altitude training. Happens in a variety of climates, but every player comes out of it seemingly faster when you didn't think they had another gear. And we've seen that from Skinner this season.
Well, it's played here and carried out by Patrick Dwyer. Nathan Gerby, Dwyer all the way across. Ainsley, good save by Fleury. That's his best tonight. Now Nathan Gerby holding on to a wrap. Chance denied by Marc-Andre Fleury. Gerby, diligent, stays with it. Stopping and starting. Nathan Gerby now puts on a show. Back to the point. Lyles loads the gun, blocked by Brian Gibbons. And the Penguins get it out. Here's Jason Megna to the middle of the ice. They attack. Going down, taken down with Brandon Sutter. And the Canes go down a man.
Now Lyles is going to put Carolina shorthanded for the first time in this hockey game. Special team situation, penalty shot in the first period where Lyles' partner, Ron Hainsey, was involved. Well, Colin Gerby on it, excuse me. It's Nathan Gerby with that stick getting parallel on Sutter, trying to help Lyles out.
The Hurricanes with a two-goal lead. Don't want to give Pittsburgh any life here. The former King, Brandon Sutter, taken down. Hudobin tested early. It's been quiet for him, and now he'll see a Penguin power play. That is number two overall, number three at home.
Well, you have a preponderance of left shots, so there should be an overload to that side. Neil there, you can always focus that he's going to shoot, not pass.
Matt Niskanen holding onto it. He'll go deep. Chris Kunitz, who has their goal. Defended by Justin Falk. Along here for Andre Sekera. Sekera in his own zone, tries to get it out, swept by Jokinen. Played here, controlled by Sidney Crosby. Jussi Jokinen, one-timer Niskanen, great block. Andre Sekera in yeoman-like fashion going down, and the Hurricanes get it out.
Did you see the overload there? All four left shots on one side. The lone righty Niskanen set up for the one-timer. What a block by Sekera.
2:40 left in period two. 3-1 Carolina. Crosby, Jussi Jokinen. Puck is on edge. It's settled down by Niskanen. Along the boards, Neal. Crosby holding again. Indirect pass for Jokinen. Jussi Jokinen now. Passes off again for Sidney Crosby. He'll dart inside Neal. Short side held by Hudobin. All the way back now, Jordan Staal. Gets in the way of Sidney Crosby and carries out. Jordan to the outside. Tries to dangle on Jokinen. Great work here by Jordan. He sets up a man. Fleury says no on the attempt by Drayson Bowman.
Well, most powerful sequence for Jordan Staal of the game, winning that race and a more desired path for him to beat Crosby.
So far, the best scoring chance belongs to Carolina. During this sequence, Fleury pads it down. Matt Niskanen flushed out by Riley Nash. 39 seconds left in terms of this Pittsburgh power play. At the line, negated by Justin Falk, and he'll move it out. And the Boobers are heard from here at Consol Energy Center.
The Hurricanes didn't score in the second period last night in Ottawa, but when you go all the way back to the beginning of that three-game road trip in Columbus, their second periods have been excellent. They've been scored, other than last night, at least a goal in all of them, and multiple goals in a bunch.
Off the stick, played by Falk. Olimata, it deflects, it's loose, kicked out with a purpose, beautifully by Hudobin. Out of the corner now, Stempniak, given a shove by Jay Harrison. All the way across, Olimata holding, high slot, Bennett, his shot tipped wide. Sutter lurking in front of Hudobin. Penalty has concluded and Gerby is out of the box. Two shots on goal during the power play for Pittsburgh. Patrick Dwyer moves it deep in the Penguin zone.
Yeah, the one shot from the righty Niskanen. Of course, Pittsburgh missing, among others, Chris Letang, that is a key element of their man advantage.
Evgeny Malkin, the list goes on and on. The high-end players that have been injured and have had considerable time out of the lineup.
Paul Martin injured in the Olympics. He's begun skating again, coming back from a hand injury.
He's just about ready. He could play very soon, possibly Thursday. Now Hainsey off the boards and all the way back out. 30 seconds left in the period.
And for those of you maybe that weren't with us in the first period, Alex Semin not available in this game due to an illness, along with, of course, Jurij Tolusti injured last night.
Along the boards now, Craig Adams moves it along, interrupted by John Michael Lyles. 16 seconds left in the period. It's been a sensational second period for the Hurricanes. Elias Lindholm has been a huge part of it. He has control. Inside for Nathan Gerby off the side of the goal. Nash. Tough angle. Again off the draping. 3 seconds left in the period. Moving down the wall is Lyles, and that'll do it. Elias Lindholm has 2 goals in this period, and he will be Chantel McCabe's guest when she delivers the PNC Bank second intermission. We'll also have part two of Ron Francis in the Twitter Lounge. 40 minutes complete here in Pittsburgh. It's the Carolina Hurricanes 3 and the Pittsburgh Penguins 1 on Fox Sports Carolina. Carolina Hurricanes hockey is brought to you by Raleigh Orthopedics. Go where the pros go. Raleigh Orthopedic. And by Golden Corral. Help yourself to happiness. And a happy night for the Hurricanes so far here in Pittsburgh. Back inside Consol Energy Center. That is the nephew of Kyle Hanlon. He is traveling with the Hurricanes. The director of broadcasting, part of the public relations staff, and Elias Lindholm with his first 2-goal game in the National Hockey League tonight.
Beautiful goals. I mean, you look at the handful of goals he's scored in his young NHL career. Has one on the King, Henrik Lundqvist, a fellow Swede, another one on Robin Lehner, and a couple of high-rising finishes tonight. And Jeff Skinner, what more can you say? To me, I get away from the 6-game point streak. I know it's a game about production, but to me, it's the other areas where Jeff Skinner is starting to take pride. And when teammates go down, as we've seen last night and tonight, he wants to be a guy that guys look to. That's very encouraging.
Playing without Jurij Tolusti, Alex Semin, who took ill this afternoon, was not able to dress for this game with a call-up from the American Hockey League and Chris Terry. The Hurricanes right now in a position, but expect a huge push from the Penguins, you would think, in this third period.
Without question, I would expect that locker room might need to have some painting done, perhaps, after that second intermission. And it goes to show in this league, it's such a close league, it's not about who's out of the lineup, it's who's in the lineup and how those players play.
That's right. Puck is dumped all the way back in. Bo Bennett for Pittsburgh. Off the stick of Jussi Jokinen. Off of Anton Hudobin. Now Loktionov tries to clear. Second opportunity. Got it out. And it's forked along by Chris Terry. Robert Bortuzzo taking a hit from Terry. Sealing the wall for the Hurricanes is Andre Loktionov. Loktionov rolls it inside. Broken up by Bortuzzo. Looking for Sidney Crosby, but it's carried out by Lee Stempniak. Pass intended for Chris Kunitz, who has their only goal. Icing is called here.
Boy, that was an interesting hybrid icing play there. Maybe
very
a break for Carolina as the Hurricanes acumen. 19-2-3 when leading after two. I've been very consistent in the fact that I love hybrid icing. There, the linesman really couldn't get in the spot to see who wins that race to the dot first.
18:53 left to go in this third period. Moved along the wall now by Brooks Orpik and out to center ice. Kunitz tied up in front of the scorer's table by Ron Hainsey. Crosby will move it back. It's stolen by Jeff Skinner. Off a stick, off of Brooks Orpik, and now turned by Elias Lindholm. Nice job to keep it moving by Lindholm, and now a steal by Chris Kunitz. Nice cut in half on him by Riley Nash.
That's the perfect job by Nash of establishing the middle of the ice, denying it, then working to seal on the outside near the board.
Boy, the puck was fumbled a bit by Marc-Andre Fleury. Now Brandon Sutter is away. Sutter over the line, shifting gears. Cut off by Hudobin, who stays upright. Justin Falk now in control, and it's played along the wall this time for Drayson Bowman.
When he was a Hurricane, that's what you always thought about Brandon Sutter, that he was just scratching the surface of what his offense could be because of his skating ability, and there, his ability to change speeds. It just never has translated to the type of production you thought it would. Still a lot of time in his career, of course.
17:47 left to go in this third period. We're having an issue with our score clock, so we'll do our best up here to keep it where you need it. Now it's played here by Brian Gibbons, shut down by Anton Hudobin. Carried out by Manny Malhotra through the center zone. He'll go cross corner. And this is icing against Carolina. The Carolina Ale House is the spot for cool bars. And the next one will be in Concord on April the 8th. And we know that there are plenty of folks enjoying the one tonight in North Raleigh. You can log on to CarolinaHurricanes.com for more details.
Well, if Manny Malhotra wins this draw, he will climb north of his 58% success rate through two periods. I have a winner here.
You do?
Yeah, hang on.
I'm hanging.
I think it's John Haight, not Height.
Oh.
Yeah, John Haight, H-A-I-G-H-T. I hope phonetically I'm okay.
Well, we congratulate him. We understand through John Chase. A huge crowd once again, and that's great. Bo Bennett holding on to it. Bo Bennett defended by Jay Harrison. Bennett recovers. Nice pass for James Neal. Neal, as they wheel a cycle to the outside for Bennett. Bennett now stick handles his way through. He'll circle. Wheel one. Hudobin makes the save, and he freezes.
Doesn't vacate the short side post. Teams seem to try to challenge that on Hudobin when he's in. I haven't noticed anything in his makeup that would make me think, but remember the goal that was scored by Anisimov Saturday, where Horton just got a puck to the net in the third period from a bad angle that led to a loose rebound. You know, teams watch these types of clips here. Look at him get that paddle, or the tape of the stick, excuse me, square on the butterfly, and then the quick glove to hold on.
Pittsburgh has had three of the four shots in this third period. Carolina outshot Pittsburgh 12-6 in the second period. Orpik Kunitz with a shot. Turned out nicely by Hudobin. Played here by Jordan Staal. Staal off the boards for Pat Dwyer, and away they go. Here's Nathan Gerby moving in on Bortuzzo. He tries to float one out in front. Jordan out of the corner. Lays it off for Dwyer. Back to the point. Hainsey traps the zone. Wristing one wide of Fleury. Loose top of your screen. Nathan Gerby is on it. He'll insert. Inside for Jordan. Jordan protecting that puck away from Brooks Orpik. Dug out by Pat Dwyer. Indirect pass finding Hainsey. His shot goes wide, and it's manned here by Chris Kunitz. A stretch pass easily detected by Lyles.
Yeah, Brooks Orpik, maybe, you know, factoring in that Jordan Staal, a former teammate, had a chance to rub him out. He didn't do so. And then we really, I think, observed one of the few decent physical collisions of this game. It has not been a physical affair.
Nice work by our crew. You can see now the score clock is back as it rolls in on Marc-Andre Fleury. Just over 4 minutes gone in this third period. The Canes come home and see the Dallas Stars, who are winning tonight in Washington. That'll be Thursday night at PNC. Over the line, Loktionov detected by Jason Megna, and they work it back.
It'll be another perfect scenario game. Dallas playing for everything.
Here's Megna. He has good speed off the side of the goal. Justin Falk defense for Carolina, and he has control. He'll lift the puck all the way out to center ice, fielded by Englund, brought along. It's Loktionov. He'll come to the outside, circle the wagons, hold on to it. Andre Loktionov fending on a pass, defended by Rob Scuderi, not out. John Michael Lyles off the boards, in deep. The Hurricanes go to work once again, but it's loose this way and picked up by Jason Megna. They jam along the boards. Pittsburgh attempting to win the battle, they do, and out they come. Here's Taylor Pyatt. little dump and chase as he tries to wheel it by Lyles, but it's covered up by Hainsey now. Now it's brought in by Sutter. His shot turned out by Khudobin. And Harrison, who made that initial play, my apologies, now he tries to clear. Riley Nash out to center ice. Skinner had it, lost it. Here's Gibbons, broken up by Harrison, and back out to center. Carolina 3-on-3 now as Patrick Dwyer will clear it in.
Yeah, a couple of loose plays there defensively on that shift for the Nash line. Be important to get back to the things you have to do with a 3-1 lead on their next shift.
Brett Belmore reversing for Radek Dvorak. Now Ron Hainsey from the corner. He'll walk it out of his own zone through center for Manny Malhotra. Moving it by Matt Niskanen. Ole Mata back for Pittsburgh. Punished a bit by Drayson Bowman. Brian Gibbons let it go. Center zone, Jussi Jokinen. Good play by Ron Hainsey. And the Penguins take over again.
It shows that he's such a veteran. A lot of players guilty of a penalty shot in the first period. Even though Gibbons doesn't score, it would have affected the rest of their night. Not for Hainsey. He's been good.
James Neal intended for Jussi Jokinen. Neal out of the corner. Gets help from Jokinen. Bortuzzo can't locate it. Pittsburgh will have to tag up as they wind it back. 13:56 left to go in regulation time. 3-1 Carolina. James Neal now giving a rough ride by Jordan Staal. Bortuzzo feeds it all the way back. Here's Jokinen. He's in. It goes high. Loose around the wall. Derby dropped it back for Jordan and back out.
Yeah, Belmore fanned on that puck and got himself in no man's land. Jokinen nearly made him pay. Good play there from Derby.
Pittsburgh offside as they cross. 13:35 left to go in the final period. The Hurricanes up by a deuce here in Pittsburgh.
In the third, and Manny Malhotra was nominated for the Master Tin Trophy for his perseverance after a serious eye injury. This summer, he was without a contract, and some thought he should retire, but his wife Joanne said he worked harder than ever to earn a spot with the Canes, training by himself when everyone else was in camp. It was really tough. Joanne said Manny never once considered giving up. He'd bring his oldest son along with him when he trained and was extra motivation. He said not only was it incredible to see his determination and then that reward pay off, but it was great to have him as a role model for their family and the many others who have been cheering for Manny to keep playing. John.
Thank you, Chantel. And we talked about it the other night. It's a great nominee by the Professional Hockey Writers Association. They do the nominating to come up with Manny Malhotra for what he has done contributing here and what he has done to get back to this level. Justin Falk now from his own zone. Lead pass. Andre Lakhdianov in control. Just about 7 minutes gone this third period. Hurricanes up by two. Here's Sidney Crosby cutting. Chris Kunitz, broken up, detected by Chris Terry. An attempt to get it out to neutral ice. Kunitz leaves it there. His stick was tied up nicely by Erik Staal. And now Justin Falk. Back out to center. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Falk lays it off, blocked the on-off by Erik. And stolen here by Sidney Crosby.
Falk has been quite good since his first shift to the game where he had an early bad read. He's recovered. By the way, on that hybrid icing, I was wrong. It's not the race to the dot. It's the referee determining when the players get to the dot in their judgment who's going to play the puck first. Just a correction on my part from earlier.
Okay. Greg Adams along the boards now. A little house cleaning is always good. Megna along the boards tries to go deep.
Oh, I was going to go in a direction there because my girlfriend is French. But I'm going to leave it there.
You should. Now here's Megna to the outside holding onto it. Jason Megna in control. He'll wind it on the perimeter. Back deep. Andre Sequeira. An attempt to hunt it down. Tanner Glass. Before checking him. Megna cut it off. The fourth line at least having some energy for Dan Bylsma here. Good shift along the boards now. Sequeira working hard for the Hurricanes. Out of this scrum. Riley Nash attempts to dig it out. Sequeira up the gut. And out, brought in offside by Derek Englund. We talked about Brooks Orpik and the hit the other night. Now let's see it. The hit on Blackhawk captain Jonathan Toews here Sunday night.
I thought this was everything that's great about good, clean hits in hockey. The puck has just left. You know, there isn't any contact, I don't think, or at least the head's not targeted or is the primary point of contact. That's just a great hit. And Brooks Orpik is a tremendous competitor. And, you know, Marian Hossa said after the game, a former teammate of Brooks Orpik, a lot of his hits are on the line. I'll tell you one thing. All 30 teams would love to have the U.S. Olympian and former Boston College Eagle, Brooks Orpik. He addressed his team, by the way, last week as they lost a couple here in this building and said that they couldn't let negativity creep into their room. They needed to stop taking offensive zone penalties. He's a leader, and he leads in action, and that's the strongest point.
They lost a game here against Phoenix, and they shut the doors, and it was players only. And when they're at the top of the heap, as they are in the division, and knocking on the door of Boston for the conference and league overall standings, you would think, well, why would they have to do that? Well, they're going to be judged on the postseason, and that's it. And there's a lot of expectations here from the goal out. Bortuzzo broken up by Malhotra, and it comes back.
And they have fought inconsistency of late. I mentioned in the first period, Dan Bylsma told me this morning that this might end up being a good thing that they're facing it.
Gerby tried to sneak it home, and Fleury got across. Nice steal by Carolina's Nathan Gerby, and it's punched all the way back in the Kane zone.
Back-to-back nights, his work ethic has been there again as the small, medium, large line has been reunited with Jordan and Dwyer.
Now it's loose. Jordan Staal off the side of the goal. In control. To the outside of Brandon Sutter. We have to give our ice crew in Raleigh, all the boys did a great job. They're the ones that came up with that tag for that line.
Yeah, very, very good tag. As you have, of course, the small Gerby, the medium Dwyer, and the large Jordan.
Puck gets fed deep. Now it's carried here by Matt Niskanen, head manning for James Neal. Good structure by the Hurricanes, awaiting in the center zone. It was Eric Staal. Mata reverses for Niskanen. On the wall, Bennett. And here they come. Halfway through period three. At the line, James Neal. Lyles right on him. Hudobin, sensing trouble, melts it down. Let's take a look at the standings. And for the Hurricanes, seven out coming in. Columbus is leading Colorado tonight. 2-1, the game in Columbus. Toronto has lost eight in a row, and they're winning tonight at home.
And what's Pittsburgh really playing for right now? I mean, Carolina, the only thing they can think about is trying to run the table, but it's still going to be very, very tough. You know, Pittsburgh isn't going to catch Boston. You could look at a couple of teams in the West. If Penguins were to reach the Stanley Cup Finals, that they'd be jockeying for home ice with. Really, it's more about getting their game in order and getting healthy.
Washington's losing tonight at last look to Dallas, who's in Raleigh on Thursday night. They're in a dogfight with Phoenix. As far as the cut line in the West, it should be a great game Thursday night at PNC Arena. New Jersey still hanging around, and they come in on Saturday night. And the Hurricanes are just going to take this one step at a time. And this one here so far has been absolutely great. Out to center ice, Sedera brought it in offside and will step aside. 9:38 left in regulation time. 3-1, Carolina. So far tonight, the Hurricanes taking care of business here in Pittsburgh. The next order of business will be Thursday night. We take you now to D.C. Verizon Center, Jamie Benn, and a tip by Tyler Seguin. That's his 33rd goal of the season. And Dallas right now has a 3-0 lead in D.C. We will see these two. They are the dynamic duo of the Dallas Stars on Thursday night.
Well, Seguin involved in that really blockbuster summer trade going from Boston to Dallas. Louis Erickson, among others, going the other way. And Jamie Benn, it has been the very definition of a coming out party for him, not only in Dallas. The power forward that can play any game, but what he did in the Olympics for Canada.
Game-winning goal. Now it's carried in. Shot taken by Chris Kunitz. Easily detected by Anton Hudobin. 9:29 left in regulation time.
Game-winning goal with teammate Chris Kunitz against Dan Bylsma in the United States of America. A 1-0 game. Beautiful redirection. It was a Bomeister feed, wasn't it, that he redirected?
Yep.
Gorgeous play for Jamie Benn. And Dallas is ahead of schedule. They're a very young hockey team that is pushing, and Jim Neal is really thinking big picture. They play a solid game under Lindy Ruff.
Louis Mata in deep now for Chris Kunitz. Patrick Dwyer for the Hurricanes, sealed off by Mata. Forged out to center ice. Here's Nathan Gerby over the line in the zone, banning on a shot, and it's still loose. Moved by Dwyer, brought out. 3-on-2. Crosby, Stempniak, Kunitz. They get confused at the line, and it's offside. Let's take a look at the Hurricanes' teeth-rattling check of the game presented by Dr. Tom Long, team dentist for the Carolina Hurricanes.
I think that Chris Terry maybe has had his best NHL game because he's done a lot of little things really well. He's bared down on pucks in the right areas, whether it be at both blue lines, at the end of shifts, had the key play on Lindholm's second goal. He's been physical a couple different times. Sakara made a great play, by the way, there to cause that offside.
His teammate, Zach Boychuk, was selected Player of the Month in the American Hockey League.
See, Zach Boychuk, who spent some time here in Pittsburgh last year, if you can just get away from thinking of him as a first-round draft pick, I think he can carve an identity for himself in the NHL. He's been good when he was recalled and played for Carolina, sort of in a more of a specialist-type role earlier this year. This is the best that Terry's looked. He's had some crisp passes, too. I've liked his game.
Good for him. Out to center ice. Played here by Brandon Sutter, by Ron Hainsey. Sutter on the gallop, goes deep. Inside for Gibbons, sealed off by Riley Nash. Another good defensive play, and it comes all the way out to neutral ice. Skuderi gave it away to Skinner. Jeff Skinner bolts in for a shot, caught by Fleury, and we get a stoppage. Let's take a look at tonight's storm tracker and see where it's taken us.
Well, the keys are 1-3, even or better after one. Getting the tied goal from Falk to make it a 1-1 game as Pittsburgh trying to take advantage of Carolina playing last night and rested Anton. He really, because the team's played so well in front of him, hasn't had to do anything special other than the first 10 minutes of the hockey game, where it could have been worse than 1-0. But since then, it's been a bit of a rocking chair affair because Carolina's been the better club.
In the first 10 minutes, the shots were 11-1 Pittsburgh, and now 26-24 Penguins. The Hurricanes turning around the emotional flow in the second period.
Sequeira again forces that delayed offsides. That's the second time in the last minute that he's done that, just with a tight gap in skating ability.
Along the boards now, Loktionov. They score! Eric Staal out in front. Andre Loktionov, a great idea. Throw it at the net. The captain was there. It looks legal. And the Hurricanes have a 4-1 lead.
Yeah, the captain's stick was clearly below the bar. The Hurricane started with it. Watch the dumping right here, guys. Fleury comes out to play it. Boy, it corrals out, but boy, oh boy, what a great job of pressuring for both Terry and Eric Staal. Two men hard on the forecheck, a reliable F3 from Loktionov, and Eric redirects the pass, or the shot, excuse me. That is a perfect forecheck. Dumping the puck where you can get in with multiple players with speed, a responsible safety valve up top in Loktionov, and then get to the front of the net.
Another multiple point game for Andre Loktionov. He has 2 points tonight. Eric Staal is 18th goal of the season. 4-1 Carolina. They want more. Here comes Dwyer. Moved off for Jordan. Off for Fleury. Loose this way for Nathan Gerby. He'll look around. Harrison at the point. Arister looking for a dip off the wall. It's Jordan utilizing his strength on Craig Adams. Now he's checked a bit by Matt Niskanen, and the Penguins look to escape harm.
Boy, I love the stylistic nature to that goal. The Hurricanes, you talked about it in the pregame show, getting pucks behind the defense and getting in with speed, where a dumping literally is just a temporary loss of possession. Eric and Terry go hard. Loktionov reads very well off of that to cover up, but get on the attack if you cause a turnover.
Simple play. Throw it at the net. Go to the net. That's hockey. Now it's cut off by Kunitz. Here's Crosby. Dangling to the outside of Justin Falk. Moved along here for Brian Gibbons. Gibbons for Chris Kunitz on a cycle. Gibbons with a shot swallowed by Hudobin.
Let's take another look at it. The Hurricanes are a team that really is not a bread-and-butter transitional team. They are more on the forecheck. You see the two players down low, Terry and Staal. Loktionov reads that and quickly knows if he can just get this to the net. Chances are Eric's already there and Terry's trying to get there, and you create a very fine redirection to beat Fleury on the short side.
Crosby takes a stick right off the draw in obvious pain from Manny Malhotra. We'll take a look.
Well, let's take a look at where he caught it. I have a feeling he caught it where, if you watched Montreal and Boston last week, where Alexi Emelin took it from Milan Lucic. Yes, he did. Same spot.
Chip wide by Crosby through the blue again. Now Gibbons holding onto it inside Sidney Crosby. Crosby guarded by Malhotra. He'll dart backhand one off Hudobin. Played here by Falk. Radek Dvorak. Drayson Bowman and out they come. Bowman now moving on Niskanen off his stick wide. This way it's Andre Sequeira. Sequeira goes deep from the corner. Crosby takes a run at Bowman. Bowman now in control. He'll move it. He'll try and get it by the Penguin captain. Along the boards, Crosby attempts to recover. Bowman punished a bit, and it pops out to Matt Niskanen.
Boy, that was a good save from Hudobin. Again, Crosby, no question, the best backhand in hockey.
A deflection off a stick, out of play, 6-11. The shot taken that time by Chris Kunitz. It's been a frustrating night for Sidney Crosby.
Boy, I mean, he can backhand the puck. I remember joking with him, I think, the year that the All-Star game was in Ottawa, and Chara and Weber were fighting it out for the hardest shot. I said, Sidney, you should compete on that hardest shot with your backhand. And he said, yeah, I could probably get it up to about 87 miles an hour. I thought that was pretty funny.
Face-off now, won by UC Okanagan along the boards. Inside it goes for Bo Bennett. Bennett holding onto it to the outside of Nash. Inside for UC Okanagan. Okanagan delays now. Lays it down deep for James Neal. Neal in control. He'll work it. Take a shot. Good block by Ron Hainsey. Bo Bennett hit hard by Hainsey. Hainsey out of the corner now. Spins off of Bennett. Getting to it is John Michael Lyles along the boards and played outside the stripe by Olimata. Steals Skinner. A give off for Nash. Back for Skinner. Inside it goes Lindholm with two goals tonight. Off the paddle of Fleury. Carried out here by Bo Bennett. And a good look at him. Bennett over the line. A drop pass for Jokinen. Jussi Jokinen threads the needle for Derek Englund. Englund down to the outside. Centers one. Nobody home. Now Bortuzzo holding onto it. A tip wide of Hudobin. Played here by Riley Nash. And the Hurricanes get it out.
Well, Skinner may be too unselfish there. There's no doubt in my mind that Jeff Skinner's the first star of this hockey game. Elias Lindholm probably trailing him. But that's what you want. You want Skinner to pave the road, and Lindholm just have to walk on that road that has already been paved.
Bortuzzo checked by Chris Terry. Eric Stahl let it go for Falk. It deflects high. It goes in the screen. We get a stoppage of play. 4 minutes, 56 seconds left to go in regulation time. We're going down the stretch in Pittsburgh. It's been a great team effort tonight so far in Pittsburgh. A four spot on the board for the Hurricanes.
Well, the first three, the common denominator, even though Skinner didn't get a point on the first one, he helps out there being double shifted to create the turnover off of Niskanen's skate. Falk scores, and then Skinner finds Lindholm on the power play early in the second. Then Lindholm and Skinner again as Terry had started the sequence, and another beautiful high shot and the perfect forechecking goal. First man pursuit, secondary support, high man, get it to the front of the net with somebody going. Eric Stahl scores.
7 points, six straight for Mr. Skinner. 4:56 left to go in this third period. Off the faceoff, Eric Stahl who has scored tonight for Chris Terry. Eric at his side, they grind along the boards. Eric Stahl attempts to dig it out. Terry now to the outside of Niskanen. Eric along the wall, in the skates of Orpik. Loose out in front. It rolls around. Niskanen had it, lost it. Here's Chris Terry. He'll whip it off the paddle of Fleury, accepted by Bo Bennett, and out he comes. Bo Bennett now gets a little back pressure from Eric Stahl, but he got it deep. Justin Falk to his corner. It's loose and back of the goal. Eric Stahl in defensive position, and now Andrei Loktionov elevates the puck all the way back.
Well, that's a powerful play from Eric Stahl coming down as the low centerman. Of course, he and Loktionov seem to rotate in who's a winger and who's a centerman from one shift to the next.
Mm-hmm. They have that flexibility. Now it's played along the boards. Patrick Dwyer. Laid back for Kunitz. All the way across, Olimata. Off the boards, he'll cradle it. Off the paddle of Hudobin. This way, it's Derek Englund. Englund now in control inside again. Here's James Neal. Neal turns, defended by Jordan, to the outside, Kunitz. Kunitz for Neal on the exchange. He'll cut, hold on to it, get room. Hudobin said no. He punched it out. Jokinen back for Derek Englund. Englund now on the flank. Kunitz all the way across. Olimata off of Hudobin. Played here by Jordan Stahl. Taken down. Golfed by Pat Dwyer. Stolen by Kunitz. His shot blocked in front by Lyles. Getting Kunitz. Kunitz one more time. In deep, out of the reach of James Neal. But Jussi Jokinen has control. He'll float one. Wide of Neal. Wide of Hudobin. Now it's Olimata. Olimata along the boards, off the skate, off Lyles. Turned to the outside by Kunitz. Walking the line, but fumbling it is Derek Englund.
Now Hudobin doesn't have a stick. He has one of his defensemen's stick, but not his own.
All right. Crosby lays it across on a change. Gibbons out in front. Good stick. Good defensive play again by John Michael Lyles. Out of the corner. Crosby leaves it there. It's moved. Crosby cuts it off away from Harrison. Pays a price though. Gibbons. Good play by Radek Dvorak. Gibbons got it back. And now a skirmish. Sidney Crosby has come off his discipline. He and Jay Harrison get it ball. And the linesmen quickly move in.
Boy, this is a very encouraging thing for the Carolina Hurricanes to have this type of night against Pittsburgh and to see the Penguin captain come off that discipline. He really started to on that stick play from Manny Malhotra on that faceoff a few minutes ago, and this just tells you that the will and desire tonight as this game has gotten deeper and deeper has been on Carolina's side. That's a good hit. Sidney didn't like it. Comes down with a free hand and continues to go at Harrison. I didn't see anything wrong with Jay Harrison finishing Crosby. Boy, I just love what Carolina, and then you, nice to see all those white jerseys in there sticking up for one another.
Matching penalties, Sidney Crosby continues to go at Jay Harrison. Each get 2 minutes for roughing. 2:47 left here in regulation time. The final meeting of the season between these two teams.
Did you think Harrison's elbow came up at all? I didn't think it necessarily did. I think that's what Crosby would probably be arguing.
Off the draw. Olivada off the glove hand of Anton Dudobin. Brandon Sutter now in control. Sutter along the boards, defended by Andre Sequeira, punched out. Missed the job that time by Justin Falk. We see it come back, no icing. Matt Niskanen away now for Brandon Sutter. Sequeira back for Carolina. Sutter in the zone, pulls up. Pushed to the outside by Sequeira. Sutter again denied. Broken up by Riley Nash. He'll stick handle his way out. It's intercepted by Olimata. Here they come again. Matt Niskanen making a drop pass. Circling in back of Hudobin. Nobody home. It's picked off by Skinner. Carolina attempts to get it out. Jordan Staal moving it back for Andre Sequeira. And here they come.
I love the fact that Skinner's not cheating to create offense. Good positioning there.
Here's Jordan moving in for a chance. Fleury shuts it down on the short side. Good move by Jordan Staal. 1:45 left in this third period.
I think it was the Skinners and the Lindholms that set the tone, and the two Staal brothers followed suit as this game went on.
Now Jason Megna through the goal crease. Lee Stempniak tries to negotiate his way through. Broken up by Ron Hainsey. 90 seconds left here in Pittsburgh. Hurricanes looking for a split on the road trip. A shootout loss last night in Ottawa, and now this. And a tremendous team effort. Down a couple of regular players. It's played here by Eric Staal. Staal in control, punished by Bortuzzo. Moved by Loktionov and back out. 69 seconds left in this third period. You see the time left on the 4-on-4 scenario. Brought along by Brooks Orpik through the middle. Jussi Jokinen and away now for James Neal. In on Hudobin. Played to the corner. Getting to it is Orpik. Now Neal, he'll settle it down. Broken up by Justin Falk. And away they go. Here's Elias Lindholm with two tonight. He pulls up for Jordan Staal. Staal throws on the brakes. Lindholm readies. Holds onto it. Floats it across. Jordan lays it back for Justin Falk. 39 seconds left. Back to 5-on-5.
Excellent outlet pass for Justin Falk. Of course, he's the guy to tie the game at one way back in the first period after Kunitz had given the Penguins the lead.
Your third key tonight, the play of Anton Hudobin. Let's check it out.
Well, it was the first 10 minutes of the game where he did his thing. After that, he's made some timely saves, but his team has been the better team since then. Made a penalty shot save on Gibbons and withstood that early push, only dealing with the one blemish in Kunitz's goal. And boy, when you can throw a good Cam Ward on his game at a team one night and then Hudobin the next. I mean, that's a pretty good dynamic duo here this week.
Good 1-2 punch. Now it's played here by Brian Gibbons coming back. 16 seconds left. The Hurricanes will win their first game in this season series, prevent the sweep. Carried in here by Chris Kunitz. Paddle down Hudobin. Three to the corner. Out of that corner, it's Olimata. Mata defended by Radek Dvorak. 2 seconds left, and this will wrap up a tremendous team effort tonight for the Carolina Hurricanes as they defeat the Pittsburgh Penguins 4-1.
This is an important victory. And it might be one in the future, John, you and I talk about, because the Penguins have had the Hurricanes number for a considerable period of time. And then when you look at Hurricanes fans, as I mentioned in the second intermission, during a turbulent year, they're looking for hope. any way they can tangibly identify it. And when you look at what the, especially the young players, 16 and 53, Lindholm and Skinner did tonight, there's your hope.
You Caniacs win tonight, too. Go to PapaJohns.com tomorrow. Enter the promo code Caniac. Get 50% off your menu-priced online order at participating restaurants. Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's and Kirk Muller could not have asked for a better effort tonight. Brandon Sutter, Jordan Staal, the big trade. They had the opening faceoff. Khudobin was stellar early. Then in the second period, the Hurricanes took over, and it was the youth once again. Jeff Skinner, Elias Lindholm, who had two goals tonight. And then down the stretch, everybody on board, and they wrap up the victory. Hurricanes Live, total post-game coverage comes your way next, right after this, on Fox Sports Carolinas.